Hello everyone, we learned FreeRTOS Task API and Queue API, then we will learn Semaphore API. Let's start the machine. As you may remember, I've explained the differences between Queue and Semaphore on FreeRTOS overview video, which is the first video of FreeRTOS series. Queue API is used to send a data, Semaphore is used to send notify, so it's used as flag. Let's see how it works. I'll start from task example that I've published, and let's define Semaphore handle. And for this tutorial, let's send semaphore from task 1 to task 2. xSemaphore give function is used with only one parameter. This is semaphore handle that will be used. And on task 2, I'll convert the for loop to infinite while loop. Then I'll use xSemaphore take function. This is used with two parameters. The first one is semaphore handle, the second one is block time. We can arrange how many ticks to check semaphore. I'm gonna write port max delay. This is the maximum value defined as tick type. So it means this will wait until got flag from semaphore. I'll write printf function to see whether the semaphore send or not. Then this is how it's used. Also, I'm gonna add task get tick count function. As you may remember, this function gives us how many time is passed from the beginning. I've added it to each task. Then we will see their executing time on the console and make flash it. As you can see, task 1 informs the task 2 after 1 second, and if we check the executing time, they are same. It means when this printf and semaphore give function runs, semaphore take function is triggered immediately. So this is what semaphore do. We can use it like interrupt, but software interrupt. As you know, we can arrange internal or external interrupt. Internal interrupt is used with timer. Timer triggers with specific time frame that we determined. And external interrupt is triggered from a GPIO pin. But this semaphore API can be used for both of them, or more complex. I'm using it to create a software interrupt. For example, on your code, there's a function you created and you would like to run another function when it runs. There are various examples we can use semaphore, you'll see it. Then I would like to show you how semaphore give from ISR function will be used. I'm gonna add necessary interrupt creating functions and library from task ISR example. Then let's use semaphore give from ISR function. It has two parameters. The first one is semaphore handle. Second one is priority. I'll write null to skip this feature. Let's increase semaphore give delay and make flash again. You see task 1 sends notify each 5 seconds, and if I press the interrupt button, it's also sent notify. This is how we use semaphore. That's all I am going to talk about today. Stay motivated and subscribe me. Let's control the controllers together.